So we are starting with the concept of tuple, okay? But I'll be discussing list also side by side, right? So let us start with the concept of tuples, and all of you please see the LCD first. Understand the basic concepts of tuple, then you will practice on your PCs. But right now, all eyes focus on LCD only. Just give the heading tuple in the registers and put your pen down and wholeheartedly focus on LCD. Is the Python window visible? Chirag, Jatin, Manjot. So what we mean by tuple, Gurkirat, please see the LCD. In the previous lecture, we were typing the list like this. And we studied that list is the collection of intermixed elements enclosed in square brackets. Japanjo, again and again, I won't pinpoint any child. Eyes on LCD. Collection of intermixed elements. Intermixed, I mean integer, float, character, everything together. Enclosed in square bracket. So this forms the structure of list. And the second concept we studied is we can change the list element at any place. What I mean by any place? I can assign any new value to any location. I may override the previous value with the new value. Clear up till here? All right. Whenever I say clear, raise your thumb up. When I say, if you have any doubt, then raise your hand. Thumb up will give me the indication that concept has gone into your brain. Now I convert the structure into some other form. I am taking the same name. I am taking one collection of elements, intermixed elements enclosed inside the round brackets, and I assign the name A to the object. This is tuple in Python. The enclosure of different type of elements into round bracket, what you call parentheses in mathematics, that forms a tuple. But there are some important differences between list and tuple which has to be gone through. First and the most important difference: list is mutable in nature. Beta, please, what you are doing, Nidhi? Focus here, bache. List is mutable in nature. Just I prove it here. Tuple is not at all mutable. If you try to assign any value, to the tuple, Python will raise error. Tuple object does not support item assignment. Assignment is not possible in tuple directly. Directly. In the coming course of time, I will tell you how we can do assignment indirectly in tuple. कहने की बात ये है बेटा, कान खींचना है लेकिन कान थोड़ा घुमा के खींचना है, सीधा नहीं खींचना है. We have to go indirectly to assign the value in the tuple. We won't be assigning directly like we can do in list. Now, the question arises, tuple is a sequence, list is a sequence, string is a sequence. How these three are similar? How they are similar? They are similar in few concepts. First, string, list, tuple, they are sequence. Triple of them are sequence. Three of them can be concatenate. Replication operation can be performed on three. आप स्ट्रिंग को रेप्लीकेट कर सकते हैं. यू कैन रेप्लीकेट टपल, यू कैन रेप्लीकेट लिस्ट आल्सो. यू कैन कंकैटिनेट टू स्ट्रिंग्स, यू कैन कंकैटिनेट टू लिस्ट, यू कैन कंकैटिनेट टू टपल्स. यू कैन डू स्लाइसिंग ऑफ स्ट्रिंग, यू कैन डू स्लाइसिंग ऑफ लिस्ट, यू कैन डू स्लाइसिंग ऑफ टपल. You can find length of string, you can find length of tuple, you can find length of list by using LEM method. We have indexing in string, we have indexing in list, similarly we have indexing in tuple also. Agar string or list mein forward indexing hai और बैकवर्ड इंडेक्सिंग है, तो टपल में भी फॉरवर्ड इंडेक्सिंग है और बैकवर्ड इंडेक्सिंग है. व्हाट इट? नाउ कम द क्वेश्चन, हाउ लिस्ट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम टपल. इन व्हाट रिस्पेक्ट लिस्ट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम टपल. List is collection of items enclosed in square bracket. Tuple is collection of elements enclosed in round bracket. List is mutable in nature. Tuple is immutable in nature. We can assign element, new element to already existing location in list, but same is not true for tuple. Just now I have proved it to you in this example carefully. I have proved this point. Got it? Am I clear with this? Now suppose this is a tuple 1 2 3 4 a. I try to concatenate it with another tuple. What is the rule of concatenation? The same rule that prevails in the list and string, the same rule prevails in the case of tuple. In order to concatenate, both the sequences must be same. Okay? The first expression is tuple, second expression must also be a tuple. Right? If I am trying to concatenate a tuple with a list, Python will indicate an error. Now I'm going to tell one most important point of tuple. Carefully observe it. Tuple का नाम A है और मैंने उसको concatenate किया integer के साथ. I try to concatenate the tuple sequence with the integer, a numeric number 2. Will it run or will it not run? Not. Python will raise an error. I try to concatenate tuple with one element enclosed in the round bracket. Round bracket, madam. It will run?
Yes.
How many says it will run? It will not. A single tuple element is considered to be tuple only and only if element is followed by a comma. This is the most drastic important point of tuple, and you will be having output questions on this concept, which I'll be sharing in group. Element enclosed in the round bracket but not having comma is not treated as tuple. It is just equivalent to numeric integer. The remedy of this problem is put a comma. You may have single element. You may have single element in tuple, okay, but it has to be followed by the comma. Ramanjit, I am not teaching to the walls of the class. I am teaching to the students sitting in the class. Okay. Now it will run. Successfully, it get executed. Got it? Then one concept which is applicable in string, in list, in tuple also. Carefully see, I run this concept in both the ways, via list, via tuple. I make a new structure. I have made a list X and the elements are from 11 to 15. All of you, please set your mask properly. Okay. In the PT1 syllabus, I discuss one operator with you, membership operator in and not in. Anybody can raise hand and tell me the literal meaning of in. Just raise your hand. Don't give the mass answering. Meaning of in operator. Loudly. That whether that element exists in the sequence or not. In. Kya ye uske andar hai? If element exists in the structure, in will return true. If element is not there, it will return false. What is contrary not in? Element nahi hona chahiye uske andar. Agar element hai, to wo false hoga. Element nahi hai, to true hoga. 11 in X. See the color of in. Orange. It is keyword. Keyword. 11 in X. True or false? 11 list mein hai. True. 12 in X. 16 in X. Oh. 16 not in X. Oh. Whenever you are having such conceptual questions where answer is true or false, 11th class, don't forget this concept. True, T is tactic. Just a minute. T is capital, false, F is capital. And they are keywords also. If true is written in lowercase or completely in uppercase, they are not considered as keywords. True and false are keywords. only and only if their first letter is capital. None is considered as keyword only if N is capital. Got it? The first N, it is capital, rest are small, it is considered as keyword. And null and none is legal empty value in Python. Online class, am I clear up till here? Chirag, Jatin, and Manjot. Any queries, any questions up till here? Three of you. Just note down their names. And date wise, write the name of the class also, those who attended. So I go with the very simple program which Gurjot was asking yesterday, meaning of traversing. Traversing kya hota hai? Bahut simple, ek simplest program jiske through hum apne sequence ke elements ko access karte. See the program first. अच्छा, वन थिंग मोर आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू, ये आपकी चीज काम आएगी. एक वेरिएबल है, कॉमा कॉमा. आई डिडंट प्रेस द स्पेस. इट इज कंसिडर्ड एज एम्प्टी स्ट्रिंग. This concept will come in the output questions. Comma, space, comma. It is not empty string. One space is considered to be one character. One space is considered to be one character. Am I clear, offline class? Oh, sorry, online class. Chirag, Jatin, Manjot. देखो यही से clear हो रहा है. ये देखो कितना फर्क है, ये देखो लग जाएगा, पता क्लियरली पता लग जाएगा. फॉर आई इन ए, ओके, आई इन ए, आई एम नॉट टेकिंग द फॉर लूप ऑफ रेंज, आई एम टेकिंग मेंबरशिप ऑपरेटर इन द फॉर लूप. आई सिग्निफाइज व्हाट ईच एल, नॉट इंडेक्स गुड़िया, each element of sequence. Index ki baat tab hogi agar range function laga hota. Ramanjit, I in this means each element of sequence. Print I Let us run it. This is first program of tuple. Check it. Check the output. This is traversing. Visiting. Simple synonym of traversing. Visiting. Assessing. Okay, Rujot, point is clear now.
Yes.
Now the comes concept of eval. Eval treats the value as you entered from the keyboard. Like I say, eval bracket input, enter the elements. Okay, please see the LCD. Enter the elements. One, int object not iterable. Input function ke through, whatever you input is treated as strain. Okay. Eval function will see what structure you are entering via keyboard. Like I say 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. What I entered? List. Eval treat it as a list. One, comma, two, comma, three, comma, four. What I entered? What I entered? Clear? But avoid the use of eval. We avoid the use of eval. Right? The simple mean, same traversing, same you can do for the list also. You can traverse the elements of list. You can traverse the element of string also. Okay? Clear? Now see here. I make a next program x equal to length of a. Now I'm going with the range for loop. Now I'll be going with the index of tuple element. Sum equal to, or simple you can say print a, comma, I, comma, comma, equal to, comma, okay. Right. Check it. मैं ये स्पेसिफाई कर रहा हूं कि हर इंडेक्स पे कौन सा एलिमेंट है. ये देखो, जीरो इंडेक्स पे, फर्स्ट इंडेक्स पे, थर्ड इंडेक्स पे, लाइक दिस. एम आई क्लियर?